Hi, I'm Miranda with Great Garden Plants, and today we're going to talk about the different levels of sun exposure. If you've been on our website, you may have noticed that we prominently display all of the light requirements for all of our plants. But what does it really mean when we say sun, part sun, or shade, and why does it matter so much? Sunlight is a major source of energy for all plant functions. It's the key ingredient to the recipe for photosynthesis, which plants use to make sugars. And these sugars are basically sources of fuel for the plant. When a plant doesn't get enough light, it can't produce enough energy to sustain growth. On the other hand, if a plant gets too much light, it can be just as damaging. You can get leaf burn and even cell death. That's why it's important to pay attention to how much light a plant needs and how much your garden has to offer. When a plant needs sun, what we really mean is that it needs full sun, which is 6 hours of direct sunlight a day. When we say full sun, we don't mean it needs sun during all hours of the day. Areas in the garden where you can find full sun are usually void of trees or any large buildings that can cast shade. But be careful with your plants that are in full light. They tend to dry out a lot quicker than plants in other light conditions, so keep them watered well. Plants that require part sun require 4 to 6 hours of direct sunlight a day. These plants require some bright light to set flower buds and fruit, but they do appreciate some relief from the hot sun in the shade, especially in warmer climates. Finally, when we say shade, we don't mean no sun. Shade plants require less than 4 hours of direct sunlight a day, typically with filtered sunlight throughout the rest of the day. Direct morning sun is better than afternoon sun, as shade plants tend to prefer the cooler morning light. Shade can be found under trees or near big buildings or other structures that cast shade. The simplest way to figure out how much light your garden gets is by observing it throughout the day. Check on your garden every so often and record whether it's getting direct light or filtered light. The time of the day that you receive sun is almost as important as how many hours, so make sure you record the times. Intense afternoon sun can feel a lot hotter for plants than cooler morning sun. Try to avoid observing your garden on rainy or cloudy days. Those aren't really representative of the light your garden gets. Once you've studied the light in your garden, try filtering through our products by light level. It's really easy to do on our website. Think your plants aren't getting enough light? Thin, elongated stems and flowers indicate that your plant needs a little bit more sun. On the other hand, if you notice that your leaves are turning brown and dry, it may indicate it's getting too much sun. But don't worry, it's really easy to move your plants to a better spot. If you have any questions, you can always reach out to us and we're happy to help. You can email us at info@greatgardenplants.com or check out our website and our blog for more great gardening tips.